50 years, we've understood that high blood pressure is a risk factor for the development of cardiovascular disease. Over that time period, our understanding of how to treat blood pressure, when to treat blood pressure, and which components of blood pressure are worthy of treatment have changed steadily over time. Observational data, now representing millions of people followed for tens of millions of person years, have demonstrated that there's a continuous and graded relationship of the level of systolic and diastolic blood pressure to risk of death from cardiovascular disease. Clinical trials initially focused on the diastolic blood pressure component, but more recently, clinical trials have focused on the systolic blood pressure component as well, which is particularly important in the elderly, in whom the overwhelmingly most common form of hypertension is isolated systolic hypertension. Newer clinical trials have demonstrated that treating older patients with isolated systolic hypertension can reduce their risk of cardiovascular disease. And still more recent trials have focused on intensive versus standard therapy, demonstrating that lowering the blood pressure to below 120 millimeters of mercury can reduce risk of cardiovascular events and deaths from all causes compared to a standard treatment of less than 140 millimeters mercury. It is likely that future blood pressure guidelines will incorporate this new knowledge and help us do a better job of treating more patients and treating them more aggressively in order to lower their risk of cardiovascular events and death.